Hey, this is Zill Brothers here once again. This one is again about free speech. And I want to speak about this attempt by Netflix employees to protest Dave Chappelle's special. Now, as you guys know, Dave Chappelle's special is getting a lot of heat. And it's getting a lot of heat because he made a lot of jokes about transgendered and gay people and things like that. And what has happened is a lot of people have stood up against him and said that his show should be straight up canceled. Now, let's just talk about this movement. There's two things that they are saying that are really dangerous. The first one they're saying is that Dave Chappelle's words are themselves violent. And the second one they're saying is that no speech is violent. So let's just talk about the first concept. The first concept is that his speech against them is violence. So any joke is violence. And I'll just read a quote from one of the people that were at the protest, Joey Soloway, creator of Transparent, a now-ending streaming series on rival Amazon that had a transgender character, talked about the line that separates edgy jokes and harmful speech. "People say to me, as a comedian, where's the line?" said Soloway. "The line is anything that makes it worse." That's such a stupid standard. Because what makes what worse? That would mean, and again, this is where they describe, this is the first point, they describe some speech as violence. The idea that some speech could be violence and something that makes anything worse can't be said would invalidate all fat jokes. It would invalidate all your mama jokes. It would invalidate all "I slept with your mama" jokes, or "I slept with your girlfriend" jokes, or "you ugly" jokes, because all of those jokes could eventually lead to somebody harming themselves, right? I can mock somebody so much that at the end of the day, they've been ridiculed so badly, they esteem themselves so little that they do something terrible to themselves, right? So that line is ridiculous because it takes away any form of mockery. And I'll notice that they never use this line of violence when they talk about the Bible or they talk about anything traditional. So this type of violence in speech, and let's just be clear, speech is not violence. It's amazing to me how sheltered a lot of people are, right? A lot of these people have never seen violence. A lot of these people have never seen somebody's guts on the street. A lot of these people ain't never been around no real guns. I remember there was a time when I was coming out of this dance club, and I had two gang members. They would have been beefing in the club. One of them was my friend. One of them I didn't know. One of them had a gun, and I was between the two of them. And I was thinking to myself, man, my life could end in a second if these guys go blazing. And we had to leave there and go to some other gang member's house to be safe. And we were hoping it wasn't going to be a drive-by. Everybody was on edge. And I'm just thinking that the people who think speech is violence have never been real. They have never understood real violence. They ain't never seen nobody just get punched, knocked out, and a whole bunch of people stomp on them to the point where you say, "Stop! Somebody could die if you keep stomping them." They ain't never seen that. They ain't never seen no real violence. They haven't been anywhere. I was thinking about a documentary I saw in Afghanistan. In this documentary, the kids, there was these bombs going off in the background. And these kids were dancing for the camera. Because for them, the camera was a novelty. The bombs going off was normal. People like this can't understand that. I saw another documentary about child soldiers in Africa. And this girl who had been raped and mutilated her whole life. She was now 14. And she was a child soldier. And they was asking her why she fighting. And she would have simply said, "I didn't know anything else." These people don't know real violence. Or they wouldn't act like, they wouldn't call other things violence. There are scales to things. And I get it. You don't like that speech. But that doesn't allow you to redefine it as violence. Real violence is a thing, and it is always higher than some words will be. Now, words can be poisonous. Words can be bad. Words can lead to some things that are worse than violence. But violence is one thing. Words are another. So that's the first thing. But the second one is silence is violence. This is the thought that if you don't stand up against what somebody else says that we don't like, you are enacting a sense of violence. And this is an attempt to make you have to say words that you don't believe. So when they say silence is violence, in other words, if somebody else stands up and say Black Lives Matter, then I gotta say it. Somebody else say Gay Lives Matter, I gotta say it. And you know, it doesn't matter whether you agree with that specific case. It doesn't matter if you don't think that that's the right issue to be saying that on. It doesn't matter what you think. You have to speak. And both of these ideas, the speech is violence and then non-speech is violence, they are an attempt to control what you can say. And that's why both of these are very troubling. So the truth of the matter is when you watch a Dave Chappelle show and you don't like his special, turn it off. Why is that so hard? Just turn it off. I never understood people who acted like they so put upon. You are not starving. You are not in Africa. You are not suffering from malaria. You were not born with AIDS. You were not born with a crack addiction. You don't have any of these problems. You got a full-time job at Netflix. And you out there protesting like you really got a point of view. You just a sad, sorry, crying human being. A pathetic adult. And oftentimes we give these cry bullies too much of a bully pulpit to push the rest of us around. And we simply need to tell many of them, shut up. Get your Kleenex, dry your eyes, man up or woman up or whatever gender up you want to do. But grow up.